KFW.com. I'm Dustin Kaufman, AM 800 News.
What are the fruits and vegetables you should avoid planting side by side?
Ask our horticultural expert now on Get Gardening.
Good morning, folks. You are tuned in to AM 800 for Get Gardening. Get Gardening is brought to you by Plantscape Windsor. Indoor tropical plant rental plans available. Call 519-972-5440 to learn more. Well, I am guest hosting today. My name is Kristen Siapis, in for Kyle Horner, and we are very excited to have Jay Terryberry with us today to talk gardening tips. Good morning, Jay. Do we have Jay this morning? I think we do.
I'm here.
Ah, good morning.
How are you?
I'm doing well.
Good.
Thank you so much for being with us this morning.
No problem.
Well, we are just waiting to get our first texts and calls. I know there's always going to be lots of questions this morning about gardening tips. If you have gardening questions, you can call us 519-792-CKLW, or that's 519-792-2559. You can also send us a text, 519-792-2559, that same number, and we will answer your gardening questions on the air. So don't hesitate. Definitely call in or send a text right now. Jay, wondering what kind of a season we're in right now. I know I am just starting to see I've got a whole patch of pepper plants in my backyard, and we're just starting to see some peppers just ready to pick off of those. I think I was a little bit late planting, and so now I'm a little bit maybe a week or two behind in harvesting.
Yeah, it's okay. Peppers love the heat, so you weren't late. You can throw peppers in probably along with tomatoes, probably the latest of the vegetables you're going to put in, with some of your viney plants, your melons and things like that. They all love the heat, so there's no reason to put those things in early. So honestly, you're not that far behind. I haven't harvested any yet. I put mine in normal time, whatever that is. I don't go by dates. I just go by the sun and the heat and the ground temp and things of that nature. But no, it's nice that we're having this nice little, I won't say cool down, but it's cooler anyway.
It's not quite cool yet.
So yeah. It's actually nice because that was pretty intense heat there for a few days. And again, things like tomatoes, peppers, they love it. Now some of our other plants, our peas and our lettuce and things of that nature that like it real cool, our spinach, they did not like that at all. And if you didn't have things covered, you know, with some type of a cloth to keep the intense sun, they've probably bolted, which means they've gone to seed. Things aren't going to taste as good as they did when it was nice and cool. But this is certainly the season for the warm temperature plants. So it's dry. I mean, we've had some rain. We had a really good rain earlier in the week, but we're probably back to the point where it's time to water. It might be time to fertilize if you haven't done that with your vegetable garden in a while. Because we've been watering so much, it probably wouldn't hurt to get some fertilizer down. You know, just little things like that. Keep your eye out for bugs. And we're almost, well, I wouldn't say almost, we're kind of into the disease part of the specter here when it comes to that season. When you get the heat and the humidity. So there's lots of things in the garden to look out for right now.
Well, we do have a question now. We're going to Manuel, who has a question about two burning bushes. When is a good time to move them? Manuel, go ahead.
Hey, good morning, Jay.
Hi, Manuel. How are you?
Fine, thank you. Jay, that box that I have in the backyard, it's very crowded. I have 8 hostas. I would like to put 2, one in each end, and the burning bush, 2 of them, I would like to move one out.
Okay.
And the other one goes in the center. So I have two hostas and the burning bush in the middle.
Got it.
I think it's, when can I do all this? Maybe in the fall or in the spring? Go ahead.
You can certainly do it in the fall. I would say it's probably not the best time to do it right now. I know you're a good gardener. I mean, you could do it now if it was an emergency. You could do it, you know, you'd have to keep things well watered, et cetera. But if you're in no real hurry to do it, certainly you could do it, you know, even early in the fall, like mid-September would probably be a perfect time. That would give the plants a couple of months to put out new roots and get established. And that way, when things start up next spring, they're ready to go. Moving those burning bush at that time shouldn't really affect the plants that much. You should still get your color, your red color out of them this fall. Just make sure you keep them well watered when you do move them. I remember you sent me some photos of that. I don't remember if it was mulched or not, but it certainly wouldn't hurt once you finish moving those plants to put a nice layer of mulch on top of the soil. That would keep the moisture in, moderate soil temperatures, etc. That would be a real good idea when you move them. But I would say a couple months from now, Manuel, I would probably be the perfect time to move them.
Thank you very much.
Alrighty, have a great day.
Have a good day, everybody.
Okay, our next question is from Darlene, who has a question about a garlic plant. Hi, Darlene.
Hi, how are you this morning? Hi, Jay Terryberry. How are you?
How are you?
I'm fine.
Good.
I call in quite often because I always have a lot of questions.
That's okay.
My husband planted garlic the same time you did.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we pulled them out a week after you did. So what do we do with the tops? He hung them up. He's got them hanging up. We just wanted to try one row, see if we were good at it or not.
Now, have you said you've already harvested them?
We've hung them. We hung them up in the utility shed.
Are
so
they all browned off? Or is there still green in them?
I think the stems were turning brown.
Yeah, mine are definitely brown. They're not fully brown yet. There's still a little bit of green.
Okay.
I usually leave the tops on until they're, I won't say dry, but until they're brown. If they're still green in there, I usually leave them, let the head take advantage of that.
Yeah, because they were popped open.
Right. Right, yeah, it's been a good year for garlic. My plants are beautiful right now. So I would say wait a little bit until they brown a little bit more. They're drying anyway, but this way they're just drying natural. If you're in no real hurry, then I wouldn't rush it. Now, do you have them hanging in an area out of the sun?
Yep, they're in the little utility shed.
Okay, and as long as you kind of keep the doors open during the day when it's really hot, you're doing everything I do. And
I just wanted to make sure because I didn't catch everything you said the last time when you did yours. And I said, well, I'll try and get in. I tried to get in last time you were on.
Right. So, yeah, your things are moving along swimmingly. So
okay.
I would just make sure, again, wait until the green's gone, and I think they'll be perfect and ready to clip off, and you'll be good to go.
Okay, thank you very much.
All righty, have a good day.
You have a great weekend. Okay,
you
thank you, guys. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Thanks.
All right, our next question is from Norman, who has a question about a fig tree. Norman, go ahead.
Good morning. How's everything going at your cottage?
It's going well, thanks. I'm heading out there right after this.
Okay. Listen, I have a fig tree. The figs are all up there. I don't know when they're going to be ready. I think maybe in another week or two.
Yeah, we're getting close.
Yeah, I live in South Windsor. I don't know where you live, but if you happen to live in South Windsor area.
I do.
Okay, fine. Off the air, I'll give you my phone number. I would have you pick some for yourself and tell me exactly what you think of my fig tree. I mean, this thing is so huge. I don't know if I'm allowed to cut branches off it in the fall or what. But, like I said, I would have the honor of you coming over and picking up.
Okay. Give me your phone number. I can see if I can get by.
I would honor because I listen to you every week.
Great.
And so when the fig tree comes up, you know, this is something special. So I know you like them. So,
oh, I do.
You can definitely prune
in the fall. I mean, if you're going to prune, that would be a good time to prune. So once you've harvested, And if you want to reduce the size a little bit, that would be a good time to do it.
Like I said, I want you to see it for yourself.
Okay, very good.
So do I leave it with the lady on the air?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah, we're gonna put you on hold and take your number. Thank you so much, Norman. Now, we've got a couple of text questions for you, Jay. I think we can do one before we go to a break. My inside potted hibiscus and outside in the ground hydrangeas are not flowering. I fertilize regularly. I also add coffee grounds. What else can I do?
Okay, you don't really have to add the coffee grounds. Coffee grounds should be put in the compost bin. You shouldn't add those directly to the soil. They're an acidifying agent, so they will acidify the soil if that's what you want to do. If you're trying to make your hydrangeas a blue color, that will help with the acidification. But coffee grounds, I don't like to add too many to the garden, if any at all. I usually put those right into the compost bin and let them break down with the rest of the compost. If your hydrangeas aren't flowering, there could be a couple reasons. One, too much fertilizer. You said you fertilize regularly. Sometimes hydrangeas will forego flowering just because they're happy. You know, you're giving them fertilizer, you're giving them water. We've had ample water this year. You've probably watered them as well. So they're just growing along without having to really put out blooms. And sometimes that happens when they're too happy. Sometimes it's good to shock them a bit, which is reducing the water, reducing the fertilizer. Now, if they normally flower at this time, and there are many hydrangeas that are flowering right now in full bloom, and they haven't flowered yet, and you don't see flower buds, they probably won't this year. It's getting a little late for buds to form. I'm not saying it won't happen, but it probably won't happen. So just reduce the watering a little bit. Definitely cut back on the fertilizer if you've been fertilizing regularly. As long as the leaves are nice and green, you've got nothing to worry about. In a severe case, we could do a little root prune, and I would wait until the fall to do that, which means just kind of get a spade and dig around about three-quarters of the way around the plant, come out a foot and a half or so from the base, and just kind of slice down. And what you're doing is you're cutting off, depending on how big they are, I shouldn't say a foot and a half, I guess you have to go out to the drip line of the plant. And just make sure you slice some of the roots. And what that does is it, again, kind of stresses the plant a little bit into thinking, uh-oh, I'm in trouble. I better set some buds for flower for next year. It's a possibility. You could also do it next spring. That would be a severe case. But I would say just reduce the water, reduce the fertilizer for starters, and you will probably see some better results, maybe this year, but more or less next year.
Okay, right on. We are going to leave it there for the moment. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back with weather in just a moment. You're listening to Get Gardening on AM800.
Take time to relax this summer and let the professionals from Plantscape Windsor help you love your space. They specialize in deck construction, fence installations, concrete work, and of course, beautiful landscaping. From a small yard refresh to complex design and consultation. Enjoy no payments and 0% interest on completed installations for up to 6 months on approved credit. Call Plantscape Windsor today, 519-972-5440. Love your space.
Now all sizes of premium roast coffee at McDonald's have a new low price starting at $1 plus tax for a small. It's great if you love great tasting coffee. $1 small premium roast coffee every single day. Must be McCafe. Plus tax at participating restaurants in Canada. Excludes delivery.
Walmart is the number one place to save on groceries. And right now you can save $1.53 on a pint of fresh blueberries. On for only $1.44 each. That's 51% in savings. Walmart. Save money. Live better.
Checking in with the AM800 Weather Center. AM800 Weather is brought to you by 93.9 Virgin Radio. Your favorite artists, their biggest hits, music, news, and more. Visit 93.9virginradio.ca. Well, taking a look at the weather, it is currently 19 degrees Celsius. That's 66 degrees Fahrenheit. Going up to a high of 27, that's 81 today, but the Humidex making it feel like 30. It will be mainly sunny, the UV index 9 or very high. Tonight, partly cloudy, going down to a low of 17. Tomorrow, a mix of sun and cloud, 30% chance of showers in the afternoon with the risk of a thunderstorm, a high of 29. or 84 with a Humidex making it feel like 32. Tomorrow night, it will be cloudy, going down to a low of 18. And that weather is going to continue pretty much through the week with highs in the upper 20s and lows in the upper teens. So nice and hot and humid with a mix of sun and cloud all week long. That's it for this week. Right now, it is 66 degrees Fahrenheit. That's 19 degrees Celsius.
I'm Noah Tepperman. You'll want to drop everything and get to Tepperman's this weekend for our gigantic warehouse clearance on now. Save more on in-stock furniture and mattresses. Take an extra $100 off your total purchase of $999 or more, or take an extra $250 off your total purchase of $1299 or more, even off current sale prices. Plus, 60% off all clearance furniture. Get here today for the best selection, because once it's gone, it's gone. Why pay credit card interest? At Tepperman's, take 60 months to pay, 0% interest, no deposit on approved credit. Don't miss our gigantic warehouse clearance on now for your chance to save even more on in-stock furniture and mattresses. Tepperman's, proudly Canadian and family-owned since 1925.
Family to family.
At Harvey's, buy one Angus burger and get the second for only $2. You heard that right. Enjoy two Angus burgers made with 100% Canadian beef and raised without the use of antibiotics, added hormones, or steroids. Meat not your style? Veggie burgers are included too. Only available until August 11th at participating Harvey's locations in Windsor, Leamington, Wallaceburg, and Chatham. Hurry before this deal is over. Harvey's, now that's a beautiful thing. Taxes extra, cheese and bacon extra.
At Toyota, we understand life's full of winning moments, like winning shotgun in an epic game of rock, paper, scissors. Boom! Paper covers rock, Carl. And we design our award-winning vehicles with your needs in mind, giving you a front-row seat to all life's victories. Except you, Carl. You're in the back. It's time for everyday wins. It's time to Toyota. Lease a 2024 Tundra 4x4 Crewmax SR from $149 weekly for 36 months at 3.99% with $5,100 down. Visit shoptoyota.ca or your local Ontario Toyota dealer today.
Taste of Circle K is back. From July 22nd to the 28th, Circle K is hosting a free food sampling event at select sites with a chance to win free Polar Pop for a year. Visit between 2 and 4 p.m. for coupons and discounts on in-store products. Don't miss out on this opportunity. Conditions apply at participating locations only. Plus, come celebrate Taste of Circle K with me, Mike K. Cook, this Wednesday from noon till 4 at the Circle K at Sandwich Parkway West and Heritage Drive in LaSalle. We'll see you there.
I'm Mallory, and I was walking home one night when an impaired driver hit me. He had been overserved in two bars before getting behind the wheel. If the servers would have called him a cab instead of serving him more alcohol, my life would be the same as what it used to be. I think servers play the biggest role in keeping us safe because it's up to them what state the person's in when they leave. Refusing service isn't personal. It's the law.
A message from Mad Canada.
Everything you need to know to grow delicious fruits and vegetables is possible with the help of our horticultural expert on Get Gardening.
Talk to myself for hours. See things you don't understand.
Welcome back to Get Gardening with Jay Terryberry. I am your guest host, Kristen Siapis. Jay, we have a ton of texts coming in right now. Our next one is about a raspberry bush. I have a raspberry bush that is out of control. Any tips on how to control it? You know what? I have this problem at home too.
Yeah, my raspberries are, now that they're done producing fruit, and it was a very good year. I had a great crop this year. They will now push out tons of vegetative growth, and that's normal at this time of year. I usually just clip it back just to keep it under control. It's going to keep pushing out that growth, especially we've had pretty good weather, like I said, with decent rainfall, etc., even though it's been hot. So just do a quick prune. I usually just tip them. Those long, scraggly branches that are shooting out all over the place, I usually just clip them back a couple feet at sometimes, depending on how much growth there is, and I will do that kind of regularly. I almost check them once a week from now until, you know, probably the end of August or early September. Then come fall, I usually even them up. You know, it's like pruning roses back. You don't prune them back too far. I just kind of get some of that scraggly growth and clean it all up as the leaves are dropping on the raspberries, and then I don't really do too much to them. I remove some of the dead, and some of those canes will die. They only live a few years. So I will cut some of those back, and then in the spring, I'll do a real cleanup. I'll get rid of all the dead that I see in there, and I will cut those raspberries down to a real strong bud. I'll go down, you know, I'll leave stems a couple of feet, sometimes a little less, but I'll go down to a real strong bud and then let them produce that way. So it's kind of an all-season prune. I don't just wait and leave it all until the fall. So just kind of trim them up right now. It won't hurt them at all. You want the vegetative growth there because that's what makes the plant strong for next year, but you also don't want it drooping all over everything. So just kind of trim them up a bit for now, and then we'll talk a little bit later in the fall about how to prune them and when to give them a good trim.
Ooh, good stuff. We do have a question here from a texter just asking the best way to take care of a lemon tree.
I don't never grown a lemon tree, but that's not an issue. Citrus are, I'm going to say they're relatively easy to grow. We had a bunch at the college for years. We had limes and lemons in the greenhouse. They were relatively easy to grow. I'm assuming this is in a container and it can be brought indoors when the weather turns. I'd certainly grow it outside for the summer. I don't know if you have it growing indoors or not, whether it was started from seed or not, or a cutting. But if you have it outside, leave it outside in the full sun, lots of water and fertilizer. You can tell by the leaves how the citrus plants are doing. They will, the veins will be quite dark green, and the rest of the leaf will be a little bit yellow. That's usually an indication that they're hungry. They like moisture. Okay, they don't like to be soaked, but they don't need to be super dry. You're trying to produce nice-sized fruit, you know, when it gets of age. So regular fertilizer, nothing fancy. A 10-10-10 would probably be fine. Maybe supplement with a little liquid fertilizer when they're dry. Full sun. Wouldn't worry too much about pruning at this stage. That's something you can clean up in the fall before you bring them in, or if they're in, I wouldn't worry about doing it till fall. You can just tidy them up a bit and then just kind of rinse and repeat for next year. But yeah, the more sun they get, the better. They love our heat and our humidity. They kind of grow in similar conditions. But they don't need a whole lot. Some of them like acidic soil. I do a little research on that. You may want to add a little acidifying agent to the soil. But other than that, as a house plant or a potted plant, they're not too difficult to grow. It's all a matter of giving them enough light and getting them enough heat.
All right. Our next question is, how much can you trim back a butterfly bush at this time of year? Ours overwhelms our garden.
Yeah, this is not really the time of year to do it. I mean, you can, but the whole idea of the butterfly bush, mine are all in bloom right now. I've got a couple at the cottage and a couple here. They're all in full bloom, and that's what you want. You know, for butterflies, they like the leaves. They like a lot of parts of the plant, but they certainly like the flowers. I wouldn't cut it back right now, but if it is hanging over sidewalks or other plants or whatever, certainly remove the parts. You can do it now. There's nothing wrong with pruning right now. It's just this is really not the time of year to prune because it's in full bloom. But if you have to prune, you can prune it hard. You can prune it, you know, not much off. It all depends on where the branches are hanging and if they're in the way. But you can certainly do it now. It's just normally not the recommended time to do it.
All right, I think we can do one more question before we need to go to a break. Our next question is, what is the best way to deal with creeping Charlie in the lawn?
Yeah, it's very difficult to control now. Earlier in the spring was easier. I had a patch between my house and the neighbors, and got very good control using the borax mixture, which if you look online, borax control for crabgrass, you will get a nice little recipe on how to control. It's quite easy. It's just your laundry borax, your 20 mule team borax, mix it in water, et cetera, et cetera. But you'll get the recipe if you Google it. This is not the time. They are pretty sturdy the plants at this time. It's better to get them in the spring when they're pushing out new growth. You'll get much better control. I'm not saying you won't get control this time of year. I don't know how much of that borax I want to pour onto a lawn or a garden area with all the heat we're having. That's the other reason I like to do it in the spring. It's cooler. Again, the plants are actively growing. There's all that new growth, and you'll get much, much better control. I applied once and got, I would say, 90% control of the patch that I was trying to get. And I did one at the cottage last year, and I haven't seen it return. So, unfortunately, I would suggest you wait until the spring. I know it's not great right now, and I see it everywhere, but it's very difficult to control at this time of the year. If you can get by and wait till spring, I would. You can try it now. You can look up that borax mixture and give it a shot on, say, a cooler, cloudy day and see if you get some control. But I'm thinking you're not going to get the good control that you would get earlier in the year.
Good to know. Good to know. I didn't realize that was something you'd only do. I mean, you could be more effective in the spring anyway.
Yeah, you can do it any time. But it's much, much better, and you'll get much, much better results doing it in the spring.
Yeah, okay.
Yep.
All right, well, if you have questions for Jay, you can call or text 519-792-CKLW. That's 519-792-2559, and it's the same number to call in or to text. Get a hold of us. Let us know what your questions are. We are going to take a quick break, and we'll be back with more on Get Gardening.
Stream AM 800 anytime, anywhere through the free iHeartRadio app.
iHeartRadio. Whenever you want it, everything is at your fingertips.
It's Canada's number one reality competition series. Get into a new episode of The Amazing Race Canada Tuesday at 9 on CTV.
Take time to relax this summer and let the professionals from Plantscape Windsor help you love your space. They specialize in deck construction, fence installations, concrete work, and of course, beautiful landscaping. From a small yard refresh to complex design and consultation. Enjoy no payments and 0% interest on completed installations for up to 6 months on approved credit. Call Plantscape Windsor today, 519-972-5440. Love your space.
The sounds of summer are back. And of course, yelling,
Bingo!
The four gaming centers in Windsor and Lakeshore have summer excitement with bingo sessions and Vegas-style gaming rooms with growing jackpots. Their bingo sessions have guaranteed prize board sessions with growing progressive jackpots games. Your summer destination with family and friends are Windsor's Paradise, Breakaway, All-Star, and Lakeshore's Power Play gaming centers. Visit WeBingo.com for all bingo session times, formats, jackpots, and their Vegas-style room hours. Play smart, must be 18 years of age to play.
What do you do when you hear ads announcing sales on mattresses and sleep essentials?
50% off! Big sale now!
Head to Sleep Country. Our unmatched buying power means great prices on top brands. And with our unbeatable price guarantee, we'll beat competitors' prices by at least 5%. If you shop anywhere else, you're paying too much. Ask a Sleep Country sleep expert for details on our unbeatable price guarantee today and start sleeping better now.
Are insects invading your home? I'm Tyler, a trained expert with Able Pest Control. In your home or business, insects can be a big concern. Just ask Emma.
I had ants and spiders in my kitchen and basement, and I was worried they would infest other areas of my home. I picked up the phone and called Able.
Nice call, Emma. Our customers have trusted Able for 100 years because we're dedicated to keeping properties and families safe.
Able, we're on it.
Able Pest Control, celebrating 100 years.
Summer is in full swing at Fred's Farm Fresh. Take home sweet golden cantaloupe, get two for $5. And organic Fuji apples are $6.99 for a 5-pound bag. Fred'sFarmFresh.com.
Tim's Maple Bacon is back, featuring crispy, naturally smoked bacon with a sweet and savory maple glaze and a 100% Canadian fresh cracked egg, all on a new cheddar croissant. Try Tim's Maple Bacon breakfast sandwich today at participating restaurants in Canada for a limited time.
It's time for Tim's.
With a mortgage renewal, there's more at stake than just your rate. Rocket Mortgage consults more than 50 lenders to offer personalized advice and find your best rate.
Let's talk about your options.
Because it's not just a renewal. It's your family's financial future. Get started today at rocketmortgage.ca/renew or call 1-833-ROCK321. Rocket Mortgage Canada UCLC is a licensed mortgage brokerage in Ontario. FSRA license number 13214.
Taste of Circle K is back from July 22nd to the 28th. Circle K is hosting a free food sampling event at select sites with a chance to win free Polar Pop for a year. Visit between 2 and 4 p.m. for coupons and discounts on in-store products. Don't miss out on this opportunity. Conditions apply at participating locations only. Plus, come celebrate Taste of Circle K with me, Mike K. Cook, this Wednesday from noon till 4 at the Circle K at Sandwich Parkway West and Heritage Drive in LaSalle. We'll see you there.
Don't miss the global phenomenon critics call thrilling and endlessly captivating.
The path to victory now is one of violence.
HBO's original House of the Dragon. New season, stream now, only on Crave. Subscribe at crave.ca.
They say talking to your plants may help them grow.
You look ravishing.
Oh, you're so grounded.
I'm rooting for you, bud.
If you really want your plants to grow, just talk to Sandy McDonald now on AM 800's Get Gardening.
Welcome back to Get Gardening. Our guest today is Jay Terryberry, giving us all the great gardening tips. I'm your host, Kristen Siapis, in for Kyle Horner this weekend. Well, we have a question. It says, I've asked you this before, but I still have a problem. I overwatered my hydrangea tree. I planted too deep. All the leaves died. I dug it up and put it in a pot, and it's still scratching green, but no leaves growing, and it's been a month now. What else can I do? Is patience the only answer?
Yes.
Green is a good sign, though, right?
The key is that you're scratching green. That's the cambium layer. That is the layer immediately under the bark, and that is where all the transfer of materials up and down the xylem and the phloem take place. So that's a good sign. Obviously, it was damaged by that, lots of water, and planted too deep. And I remember the conversation or the text from before.
Right.
So yes, and again, it's you want it to dry out in between waterings. You still have to water it. You don't want to let it dry out to the point where it's bone dry, but let it dry out in between waterings. You're still going to water it regularly. The fact that you have it in a pot is good because it will drain, so there will not be any excess water in there. I don't know if you've fertilized it since you've put it in the container. It probably wouldn't hurt to give it a shot. But yes, because it's still green, I would worry about it. It should have some leaves, but patience is golden at this point in time. Just keep checking. To make sure that you still have some green on there, water it when it needs to be watered, and I would keep it in a, maybe get morning sun, afternoon shade area. You can move it around if you have to, and just kind of wait. I think that's all we can do at this point in time. Hopefully it's going to push out some leaves here in the next couple of weeks, and that way it can build up some energy for next year. You can get it back in the ground. You could plant it in the fall. If it starts getting some leaves and it looks like it's making a comeback, I would get it back in the ground. Obviously, don't plant it low like you did before, and get it into the garden, plant it a little bit higher, and mulch it in, and it'll probably get through the winter fine. I would do that by mid-September. So we got a couple months here to see if it's going to push out some new leaves or not. So text me again. Keep it going. Let's see how we're doing here.
All right. So we have a question. I hope I don't butcher the name of this plant. It is a euonymus bush.
Yep.
I don't know this one. A euonymus bush has white spots all over the trunk and leaves. White spots all over it. How should I treat it?
Yeah, it's scale. Euonymus scale. It's very, very common. We've been talking about this for probably 30 years, as long as I've been doing this show. It's very, very common on many types of euonymus, the old Emerald Gaiety euonymus, and there's the gold varieties. Scale is an insect. It's very, very common. It will get all over the leaves, get all over the stems. Difficult to control. You can try, again, you can't really try and wipe it down, but that is a way to do it. They do become active. The little scale become active. You can try soap and water to help give control, but the best way to control is dormant oil. If you can get some dormant oil on in the fall, I wouldn't do it now when they're actively growing, but in the fall, because what it does is it kind of coats the scale insect and suffocates it. That's the way it works. So you want to put that on in the fall, and then I would do it again early spring. And you should get decent control that way. There's also, you know, some insecticides like pyrethrin and things like that that'll probably control the scale in the crawling stage. Or, like I said, even soap and water will give you some control of that scale this time of year. You can blast it with a hose, you know, put the breaker on the end of the hose and blast it as well. Difficult to control this time of year, but the dormant oil is the key, kind of later in the fall and again early in the spring. And you're going to have to do it pretty well every year. It's a difficult insect. It loves euonymus, and that's just the way it is.
Right on. Okay, one more question. I from a texter, I get little black bugs on my peppers biting holes. What are they, and what can I use to get rid of them? I have tried soap and water.
Yeah, they're probably, there's a lot of beetles around this time of year, and I'm not sure what type they may be. You know, it's Japanese beetle season. I've got a few around. I haven't had a lot this year. I've heard people say they have had a lot. But there are many, many types of beetles out right now. And
I hear it's a bad year for bugs overall.
Oh, absolutely. The mild winters are killing us. We need a really, and I know people don't want to hear this, but we need a really severe winter. We really do. We need cold, you know, minus 15, 20 nights to really help control insect pests. They're living through the winter, and they're not being damaged at all by the cold. So we're just getting just tons of insects, and it's a big problem. It really is. We need a biting winter. We really do.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, back to the beetles. Yes, soap and water usually doesn't do much to hard-shelled insects, and the beetle is a hard-shelled insect. They do well on soft-shelled insects, you know, caterpillars and things like that. They will deter them somewhat. But usually they don't do that much. You can try some of the other insecticides, the pyrethrin. The other thing you can do, and I've heard Sandy mention this before, is just take the hose and blast them. Again, I just mentioned it before with the scale. It might help a little bit. Not much, but it might help a little bit. But with beetles and things like that, just take the hose to the plants once a day and literally knock them
right off.
Right,
manual remover is the way to go.
Send them flying. It sometimes is the best way to go. They're only going to be around for a little while longer. They're usually not here for a long time because they're going to lay eggs and they're going to go into the soil. You're going to get your grubs and, you know, the adults are going to die. So they're only here for a short amount of time, but they do a lot of damage in a short amount of time. I had some roses that were getting eaten, and I put a little bit of insecticide on there, and it seemed to calm them down, and I haven't seen much since. So I'm thinking that patch has moved on. So there's a few suggestions.
All right, we do have a caller on the line. Tilly is on the line with a question about boxwood. Whether we need to cut it back after some caterpillars seem to have gone at it. Let's see here. Tilly, are you with us?
Yes.
Hi, go ahead with your question.
Yes. Could you tell me, once my boxwood got eaten away, is there any chance it could come back, or should I just cut it right off?
Oh, no, absolutely. I think a lot of people this spring either pruned back or removed boxwoods early. We did have the box tree moth, which is devastating, and it's still with
us.
It comes in many phases. We could get 3, 4, 5 different infestations of it this year alone. So if you got there was a product called Safer's BTK that many of the stores had, and it controls the caterpillar stage and works quite well. I've talked to a few people that have applied it and had very good success. But you'll have to keep your eyes open because those caterpillars could come back. You'll see the moths flying around the boxwoods, and you could see the little caterpillars again. So keep applying that spray. Again, we were just kind of talking about it with some hydrangeas a few minutes ago. If you kind of scratch your thumb on the bark and you get a little bit of green underneath, that means the boxwoods are still alive, and they will push out new leaves, so there's no reason to prune them back yet. Even though they don't look great, give them a chance to break out in new leaves, and then just keep applying pretty well for the rest of the season. You're going to have to apply probably into September because we'll probably still have the insect problems, the box tree moth, until then. and then probably continue on with it next year as well. I don't know if they're going to come up with anything better for control or these insects are going to be as bad, but they're certainly bad this year. But I think people pruned and removed those boxwoods a little bit too early in the spring. They should have given them a chance to come back. You know, water them, fertilize them, and they'll come back. They'll push out new leaves.
Thank you very much.
All righty. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Excellent. Well, we are going to take a quick break and we'll be back with weather in just a minute. You are listening to Get Gardening. If you have gardening questions, please give us a call, 519-792-CKLW. That's 519-792-2559. We'll be right back.
With food basics deals like 18 large white selection eggs for just $4.75, you'll be saying, oh my wowza! Shop in-store and online until July 24th. Food basics, always more for less.
Hey, would you donate plasma for patients in need?
Can you make a trip to a donor center as part of your plans?
Please donate. Lives depend on it.
Half of people in Canada say the reason they have never donated plasma is because they've never been asked. So we're asking, in as many ways possible, for your help to strengthen Canada's lifeline by making a donation this summer. Make all the difference to someone in need. Book today at blood.ca.
Now, all sizes of premium roast coffee at McDonald's have a new low price starting at $1 plus tax for a small. It's great if you love great tasting coffee. $1 small premium roast coffee every single day. Must be McCafe. Plus tax at participating restaurants in Canada. Excludes delivery.
Checking in with the AM 800 Weather Center. AM 800 Weather is brought to you by Advanced Basement Systems. Trust them to give you the extra space you need by fixing your wet basement or crawl space. Get your free quote, serving all of Windsor Essex since 2003. Well, taking a look at the weather out there, it is 19 degrees Celsius. That's 66 degrees Fahrenheit right now. Looking ahead at today, it is going to be mainly sunny with a high of 27 or 81. The Humidex going up to 30, so it's going to feel very hot out there. The UV index 9 or very high. Slap on that sunscreen before you get out there. And tonight it will be partly cloudy, going down to a low of 17. Looking ahead at tomorrow, a mix of sun and cloud, 30% chance of showers in the afternoon with a risk of a thunderstorm, high of 29 or 84, another very hot day. Humidex going up to 32 tomorrow. Tomorrow night, cloudy with a low of 18. Looking ahead at this week, Monday will be a high of 29 with a low of 18. Tuesday, a high of 28 with a low of 19. And Wednesday, a high of 27 with a low of 19. So high 20s during the day and high teens in the evening all week long. Right now it is 66 degrees Fahrenheit. That's 19 degrees Celsius.
AM 800 CKLW. We go where you go.
On iHeartRadio.
Updates and analysis, opinion and commentary.
The latest audio and top podcasts.
Plus,
browse curated playlists like Songs of the Summer 2024.
Oh, it's getting hot in here.
Windsor's AM 800 CKLW.
Take us everywhere, easy and free.
On iHeartRadio.
There's never been a better time to discover the 2024 Lincoln Corsair.
Experience unparalleled connection, comfort, and confidence.
Along with lease APR starting at 1.49% for up to 48 months, including 1% loyalty rate reduction.
Drive home the Lincoln Corsair this season and discover the power of sanctuary.
Start by booking your Corsair Discovery Drive today at lincolnofwindsor.com. Lincoln of Windsor, a proud member of the Raffiato Group.
Coulter's Furniture Massive Reno Sale is on now. Save 15% off all regular priced items, 20% off mattresses, 25% off recliners, and save a whopping 35% off all markdown items. While supplies last, hurry into Coulter's Furniture at 1324 Windsor Ave.
Thinking about lunch? Take a trip down the block to Kelsey's and try our tasty new lunch trio menu, starting at only $14.99. Enjoy faves like the half barbecue chicken Sammy with choice of side and soup, only at Kelsey's, the original Roadhouse. At participating restaurants, taxes extra.
Taste of Circle K is back from July 22nd to the 28th. Circle K is hosting a free food sampling event at select sites with a chance to win free Polar Pop for a year. Visit between 2 and 4 p.m. for coupons and discounts on in-store products. Don't miss out on this opportunity. Conditions apply at participating locations only. Plus, come celebrate Taste of Circle K with me, Mike K. Cook, this Wednesday from noon till 4 at the Circle K at Sandwich Parkway West and Heritage Drive in LaSalle. We'll see you there.
The sounds of summer are back. And of course, yelling,
Bingo!
The four gaming centers in Windsor and Lakeshore have summer excitement with bingo sessions and Vegas-style gaming rooms with growing jackpots. Their bingo sessions have guaranteed prize board sessions with growing progressive jackpots games. Your summer destination with family and friends are Windsor's Paradise, Breakaway, All-Star, and Lakeshore's Power Play gaming centers. Visit WeBingo.com for all bingo session times, formats, jackpots, and their Vegas-style room hours. Play smart, must be 18 years of age to play.
Rob's Pharmacy, 1765 Sprucewood Ave in LaSalle, providing pharmacy services focused on you and your family. Robspharmacy.com.
Helping you get to the root of the problem.
Here's Jay Terryberry on AM 800's Get Gardening.
Welcome back to Get Gardening with our guest, Jay Terryberry. I am your guest host, Kristen Siapis, in for Kyle Horner this weekend. We do have a call from Matt. Matt, go ahead with your question.
Hi, good morning. Quick question for you, Jay. I've got a magnolia bush that I put in, I don't know, maybe 4 years ago. It's in a nice spot in the backyard, like partial sun, partial shade. And it seems to be pretty happy there. But around this time of year, every year, the white powdery mildew starts to get out of control. And the leaves go from really nice glossy green and they start kind of curling and withering. Right. And I've tried all kinds of things. I've tried Listerine. I've tried baking soda and water mixtures. And I'm trying to keep it on the natural side. I have animals that I like to let outside. So I was just wondering if you had any suggestions for control. Like, I've heard that that kind of thing comes up from the grass and the ground around it, but it's hard to find good information online.
Yeah, it's kind of difficult. I've never worried or been a great proponent of the coming out of the ground and coming out of the grass thing. It's a lot about air movement. Now, you said it was in the backyard. What's your situation like back there? Are you fenced? Is it garage, tree, other trees?
Yeah, it's in a corner, so it's got two wooden fences on that corner.
Yeah,
where they meet up, and then there's a maple tree that kind of like is in my neighbor's yard. That
right.
Goes right close to the fence, and it was recently trimmed back, so the bush is actually getting more sun. But it does get a lot. It does get, like, you know, I see it moving when the wind is blowing.
Right.
So,
but that's a tough situation with a fence like that. And I know you see it moving every now and then. But the problem is, generally early in the morning when we get the dew, it probably takes longer for that dew to dry up on the leaves, and hence the situation with the powdery mildew. How's now the plant itself? Is it pretty full? The magnolia, is it?
It grows really well.
Like, now, has it been flowering for you yet?
Yes, it has. In fact, it's just getting ready for a third round, which is unusual. Normally, it's only twice a year.
Great, yeah.
Or twice in the summer.
I don't know if I'd want you to prune it this year because you're gonna forsake some blooms. Maybe right after it finishes blooming. I would get in there and thin it out a bit.
Yeah.
Try and take out some of those branches that are growing in the middle of the plant. And again, that allows much better air movement. That will certainly help. And you next year, especially in the spring after that first major flush of flowers, it would certainly be nice to get in there and maybe thin it out a little bit more. That will definitely help the plant. I can't really... you said you've tried to spray a few things on it to try and keep the mildew under control. I don't really know if that's going to be beneficial or not. Certainly, keeping the plant well fertilized is going to help. They're pretty big feeders with all the flowers they push out and the big leaves. They do like feed. So regular fertilizing, I would probably fertilize it a couple times a year. I would fertilize it in the spring, and I'd probably fertilize it again late spring. I don't want to fertilize it into the fall unless it's dormant. You know, you could do a dormant feed like we do with a lot of our trees. You don't want new growth being pushed out in the fall. That's going to be, you know, it's going to damage the tips of those branches and things if we do get a severe winter. But a couple fertilizations early spring and maybe late spring would definitely help, or a dormant feed after the, you know, after it's done pushing out all the growth, maybe October or November, okay, would certainly help it as well. That would be a real bonus. But again, the air, in my, just by listening to what you're telling me, I think it's a lot to do with air movement.
All right.
And cool. I think you really need to try and open that up some if you can. You know, like you said, the maple tree was headed up. I would do that on a regular basis, but I would actually prune the plant itself to get more airflow and more sunlight in there.
All right. Awesome. Thanks a lot, Terry.
All righty. Have a good one.
All right. Bye-bye.
Okay.
All right. We're running short on time, so maybe we can do a quick lightning round of a few questions. I've heard that if you cover an area with a fairly thick layer of salt, nothing will grow there. Is that true?
I would have to believe. I've never really done that before, but
I guess if you salt it,
it would fry everything. That's for sure. I mean, if you're doing it on a gravel driveway or something
it
like
is,
that,
yeah, it's a gravel area that's constantly needs to be weeded. So.
And that would probably work fine. My biggest issue is when it starts raining. Where is that salt going to end
up? Where will it run off
where
to?
Where is it going to run off to? So that's always a concern of mine.
All right. Can I put bone meal on hydrangeas and hosta plants through spring into the fall?
You can. It needs to be worked into the soil, though. Bone meal doesn't travel very well through the soil. So if you're ever going to add bone meal to anything, you literally have to dig it down into the soil where the roots are. You can't just throw it on the surface because it does not travel through the soil.
When is the best time to trim back trumpet vines, and when do they bloom?
Right after bloom. They should have bloomed already. Some might still be in bloom, but the ones that I saw bloomed earlier in the year. And the best time to prune almost anything that flowers is immediately after it's done blooming.
The leaves on my 20-year-old oak tree are curling up and turning black. What do I do to save the tree?
Yeah, there's oak wilt around. Sandy talked about it earlier. Do not prune. You cannot prune when it's in active growth. It's easy to transfer that around. You should really only pruning should be done in the winter on those. There's not a whole lot you can do about it. Just keep it healthy. Fertilize it in the fall. You know, with tree spikes. But do not prune right now. You open up wounds, and it's going to make it worse. Just do a little research on this. I think you're probably dealing with oak wilt, which is going to become a problem around here if it already hasn't.
Where's the best place to get information when you say do a little research?
Just online, I would just wherever, go online and look up oak wilt, and it will say control, and you'll get some very, very good points. And again, just make sure you're on a good site. You know, some of these sites are from the south or from Missouri or wherever. Try and get something from University of Guelph or Michigan State University, something like that, which is, you know, in our range, and you'll get better local information.
Right on. Is now a good time to put down grub preventer?
Yeah, it's a little early. I generally suggest mid-August through probably the end of September. You're probably going to get your best control.
All right, here's a question about cucumbers. This actually happened to me when I tried cucumbers, too. My cucumbers are loaded with blossoms and starting to produce cucumbers, but the foliage is starting to get yellowish spots all over and then dry up and die. This is spreading quickly through all the vines. I don't see that it's being caused by bugs, but I have been applying a bug control product. I also sprayed with a copper powder solution, but it doesn't seem to have helped.
Yeah, the viney plants get a lot of diseases this time of year, and it's because they're so close to the ground and there's not a lot of real good air movement down there. One of the best things you can do, again, is kind of lift them up a bit sometimes to get some air under there. I know it's a difficult thing to do. I'm not sure of which disease it is. They're probably right. It's probably not insects. It's probably a disease, and it has a lot to do with the humidity. They do like the heat, but the humidity really kind of wreaks havoc on them. I thought they were going to say the buds, the flowers are falling off. As long as the flowers aren't falling off, you're probably still going to be okay. So keep your eye on that.
No, I had this too where cucumbers, my cucumber vines were all turning yellow. The longer they got, the yellower they got. And then the cucumbers themselves started out, I might get one or two that were great. And then they were all turning yellow and going bad halfway through.
That's going to be the issue. So I would, again, I'm not sure which disease it is. Do a little bit of research. Make sure if you do spray, spray in the evening or in the morning when it's cooler or on a cloudy day. Don't do it in the full sun. It may be a little too late to catch it. I know they get mildew as well, but this doesn't sound like powdery mildew at all. So,
all right. Well, that is all the time we have for today. Jay, thank you so much for being with us this morning. Get Gardening is brought to you by Plantscape Windsor. Indoor tropical plant rental plans are available. You can call 519-972-5440 to learn more. This has been a great morning. Thank you so much for being with us today. Thank you, Jay, and thank you to our listeners. That's all for me. Thanks for listening to AM 800. I'm Chris.
When news breaks, we're the first to tell you.
On air.
And online.
From Windsor, Essex, this is AM 800 CKLW.
An iHeartRadio station.
It's 9 o'clock.
19 degrees in Windsor, Essex. Mainly sunny today. The daytime high reaching 27, but will feel like 30 or 86.